everybody. I am Sanya, your host for today's live talk all about skin well-being team. I am sure all of you must be keeping good health. Today, we are going to discuss about our skin healthy with focus on urticaria or hives, which we are near and dear ones might well have encountered at some times in their lives. Urticaria is characterized by a round rash on the skin that itch intensely, and it may due to chemicals in certain foods, allergy to certain medications, instinct sting, sunlight, and sometimes the cause of hormone as well. As per study published in India Journal of Dermatology, Venereology and Leprosy, more than 1/5 of the population suffer urticaria. 60% of patients are in the age group of 20 to 40 years old, and incidence is higher in older age group as well. Urticaria is classified as acute and chronic, but the most important part is not to ignore and do self-medication when worsening symptoms. Consult your nearby qualified skin specialist immediately for an early remission. In today's digital world, it's a boon and a blessing that if we get to get here an expert dermatologist online about urticaria and its type, how we can prevent it, the kind of tests required for its diagnosis, the right treatment and management approach for an early life. So ladies and gentlemen, girls and boys, certified dermatologist, Dr. Priyanka Sukaria, 50 years experience in space. She is associated with various national and international dermatology societies. Today, we are talking to her as she has been president of Gujarat Derma Association and also in National Derma Association team as well. She is highly active on social media for public awareness and programs and talks as well. A very warm welcome to you, Doctor, and it's a pleasure to have you today with us as we are going to discuss that is urticaria.
Thank you.
And doctor, as we are going to discuss urticaria, so let's start with the very first question. That is, what is basically urticaria? How we can define urticaria?
See, basically urticaria, or commonly called as hives in English, right? So it is a condition in which you can get anything from small patches which look like mosquito bites, which can be very small or flat, or they can be even as big as a 1 rupee coin or 2 rupee coin size, which can be raised. Sometimes it is there are no patches and you just see the scratches on the body. That is called dermographism. So there are different varieties of urticaria, and like I said, it is commonly called hives. So any kind of itching on the body which leads to rashes is called urticaria. It could be acute or chronic, so anything less than 6 weeks or more than 6 weeks. So it's a medical definition.
Okay, so that means any rashes that 6 to 8 weeks se zyada agar koi rash hai, that can be defined as urticaria.
Nahi, agar 6 weeks se kam hai to usko acute urticaria bolte hain. Agar 6 weeks se zyada hai to chronic, matlab purana urticaria.
Okay, so there are two types, that is acute and chronic urticaria. Okay, doctor. And doctor, when we are talking about urticaria, what are the main causes of urticaria?
See, basically urticaria is a condition, like how you get fever. So fever or urticaria, it could be anything, right from allergies. So if it is food allergy, it is drug allergy, it is contact allergy, someone was in swimming pool and you get allergic rashes. Then there is infectious urticaria. You have some infection in the body, so you must have seen a lot of patients with viral infection, as simple as dengue and all that, who start getting itching. So it could be because of any infection, viral or bacterial, in the body. Any chronic conditions also, some systemic internal diseases also, so you can get urticaria because of that also. So it is a symptom which happens due to some disbalance in the body system.
Okay, doctor. And doctor, as you mentioned that it is a kind of allergy, so how does urticaria exactly look? And, as you've mentioned that it is a form of allergy, so how does exactly urticaria looks, and how a patient can define that, this is urticaria and he or she has to refer to a doctor?
See, basically there are different varieties. One, you don't see anything and you just feel burning and itching. Second, you see there is no raised rashes, there is just redness, red patches on the body which are not raised. Then third, when you itch or scratch, you start getting lines on the body. You know, if you scratch in a check, with your nail or something, so it becomes two lines. Fourth, it looks like multiple mosquito bites. So it looks like raised patches. So these are the different categories of urticaria. And in severe form, you can even get eye or lip swelling. So it's very, your eyes started watering and it is very difficult to speak also. That is the riskiest urticaria in which you have to inform the doctor as soon as possible.
Okay, doctor. And as you have mentioned that sometimes the lips and eyes are also swelling. Is urticaria a serious disease?
See, the thing is, it is, you cannot measure the intensity, by yourself. The doctor decides it. So suppose you are having itching and you are letting it go and suddenly you swell up. Aapne kabhi kabhi movies mein dekha hota hai ki wo aise batate ki kuch khaya and the person gets choked. So basically it is, your throat gets choked or your lips get choked. So you are unable to breathe. So just if you feel you are having uncontrollable itching or rashes, you have to see a doctor. But yeah, the eye and the lip urticaria, it's called angioedema. It is a little risky and you have to see the doctor, any nearby doctor.
Okay, and doctor, here you have mentioned that if someone is having urticaria, they should go and refer a doctor. Sometimes you might also have come across a lot of patients who have applied over-the-counter medication or over-the-counter medicines, and then, now the condition is worse. So, what is your suggestion to the people who self-medicate urticaria?
See, Indians, we have a tendency of, even though you are very, very easily, the doctors are available. I mean, in every 1 kilometer, there must be a doctor, not dermatologist, but any doctor. So you should never self-medicate because you're risking your own life, one. And you should never self-medicate your relatives also, never go to the medical shop, because if anything goes wrong, then sometimes you have irreparable damages. So for any disease, we always say never self-medicate, and never even in urticaria, even in simple diseases like pimples, you should never self-medicate. So you should always go to the doctor and do it.
Right. And doctor, in this era of social media, there are a lot of information as well that if the urticaria looks like this, apply this, or homemade remedies as well. What is your suggestion to the people who applied home remedies or the information which is on social media?
See, I'm not against home remedies, but if the doctor tells you to do home remedies, sometimes that again postpones your visit to the doctor. If you are having, say, some internal disease which is causing urticaria, aapko kuch bhi infection hai aur aapne 3-4 din ghar pe home remedies se wo kiya, time waste kiya, to jo shayad urticaria hafte mein mit jane wala tha, aapko bekar mein 15 din dawai khani padegi, one. You are worsening your condition. So basically, any kind of disease should not be home medicated. Matlab doctor ko bata ke phir you can ask them, sir, main ghar pe kya extra dhyan rakh sakta hu. Disease has to be treated by a doctor.
Right, absolutely. And as you said, if somebody is taking home remedies as well, agar wo home remedies bhi use kare, so they have to refer to a doctor first, because a doctor can definitely tell them what is right and what extra care is required if someone is having urticaria. Doctor, you also mentioned about two urticaria, that is chronic and acute. So what are chronic urticaria hives and how will they go away?
No, it's basically for medical terminology. So any rashes or hives which is less than 6 weeks is called acute, and any which is more than 6 weeks is called chronic. So it is more for the understanding of the doctor, because then if you can give them a proper, agar aap doctor ko samjha sakte ki mujhe itne time se hai, to unko investigation karne mein ya medicine likhne mein easy rehta hai, kyunki uske disease condition change ho jate hain. Matlab chronic ka reasons for chronic urticaria is different than reasons of acute urticaria. So that is, aapko jo history dena hai aapke doctor ko, that has to be proper. Jisse aapka diagnosis proper, don't try to mislead your doctors. Don't try to, kyunki wo aapka benefit wo nahi hoga. To uske liye hum samjhate hain ki aap ek proper history rakhiye. उससे मतलब आपको उनको बताने के लिए इजी रहेगा.
राइट. एंड डॉक्टर, एज यू सेड दैट यू नो समटाइम्स पीपल हाइड एज वेल कि हम अर्टिकेरिया कब से है कब से नहीं है, बट एज यू मेंशन दैट अपने डॉक्टर को सही बताइए बिकॉज इट इज इंपॉर्टेंट. डॉक्टर, समथिंग डज नॉट लुक अर्टिकेरिया, दे फील दैट शूटिंग इट इज नॉट इंपॉर्टेंट. हाउ, व्हाट आर द पोटेंशियल कॉम्प्लिकेशंस वी कैन से इफ अर्टिकेरिया इज नॉट ट्रीटेड?
See, like I said, allergy is a very notorious thing. You know, one, ek, it'll extend. मतलब अगर वो जल्दी खत्म हो सकता था, the body allergy rises, the histamines rise, और आपको ज़्यादा दवाई खानी पड़ रही है, simple. Second, if it is related to your gut system, मतलब stomach में कोई infection है या कुछ, तो आपको और आगे issues हो सकते हैं. Third, like I said, the most riskiest one is eye angioedema and lip angioedema, मतलब which could be fatal to life. तो वो सब हो सकता है. कुछ कुछ केसेस में एलर्जीज काफी लोग इन्हें अपने खींचते हैं, तो वो लॉन्गर रन ऊपर अगर जैसे एलर्जी बहुत हुआ बॉडी में, सो यू कैन इवन गेट एस्थमेटिक अटैक्स, यू कैन गेट अदर नोज एलर्जीज एंड ऑल दैट, बिकॉज स्किन अर्टिकेरिया एलर्जी ऑफ द नोज एंड लंग्स आर लाइक ब्रदर सिस्टम, वो बॉडी का एक सिस्टम पकड़ लेता है, सो दैट ऑल यू कैन गेट इन टू ट्रबल लेटर ऑन.
Right. If it is not treated, then you know these are the troubles which can happen. Okay, okay, doctor. And doctor, monsoon season has already arrived in India, and sometimes you know in monsoon there is humidity, so a kind of rashes, a lot of things happen, and you know people wear wet clothes. Thus, this can also be a cause of urticaria.
हाँ, जो जो बेसिक अर्टिकेरिया या एलर्जीज होते हैं, जैसे क्योंकि ओवरऑल मस्कीटोज या कोई भी इंसेक्ट ज़्यादा बढ़ जाते हैं. सेकेंड, मॉनसून इज द मोस्ट फेवरेट सीजन फॉर एनी काइंड ऑफ बैक्टीरियल और वायरल इन्फेक्शन बिकॉज ऑफ ह्यूमिडिटी. तो आपको फूड पॉइजनिंग, यूरिन, मतलब कोई भी इन्फेक्शन होने का चांस बढ़ जाता है. इट इज मोर फेवरेबल फॉर द जर्म्स मल्टीप्लाई, इन सिंपल लैंग्वेज. तो आपको रैशेज ज़्यादा हो जाते हैं एंड बिकॉज ऑफ ह्यूमिडिटी वो उसको बिजी रहता है बॉडी पे. Like for all things, avoid eating outside, especially raw food. Okay, and try to wear covered clothes, especially when we are going to parks and all that, and use a good mosquito repellent, especially for kids. So that is again, and if you have any kind of cold, cough or stomach infection, see your doctor immediately. Not urticaria, simple infection. You should see your doctor, and you can have lukewarm water. You can have more of vitamin C. मतलब जो healthy food रहते हैं, जैसे मौसमी हो गया, pomegranate का juice हो गया, those are very healthy. They have good immunity enhancer. Haldi हो गया, that those are home remedies which you can take care to detox your body and make it more healthier. So you'll get less allergic rashes.
Okay, that means doctor, eating healthy can help in this season.
Eating healthy is there in every season, but more in monsoon, and because you're tending, you tend to fall more ill in monsoon season.
Right. So because as doctor said that in the monsoon season you have to take care especially of your health, so you can eat good avoid eating fat food and you know the food which you know. Doctor, as we are talking about urticaria, does urticaria is caused by stress as well? Are this any connection with stress and urticaria?
I see any stress, not doing exercises and having good hormones in the body, not you know laziness and all that, they all decrease your immunity. So if your immunity is less, your body doesn't fight. So if the germs will spread faster, that is the only answer for that. So basically stress causes sleeplessness, and the good, if you are not having a good sleep, your good hormones don't get secreted. So that's why you tend to get more ill, whether it is urticaria or any disease, skin disease or lifestyle disease for that purpose.
Okay, doctor. That means it is interconnected. If you are sleeping properly, you have a good cycle, then you can be safe from many more diseases, like hepatic area as well. So, doctor, as you mentioned about sleep, is it like that the hives or urticaria get worse at night and change more at night? It is like that?
It is that. या ट्रू एनी बॉडी सिस्टम भगवान ने ऐसा बनाया है कि जो हिस्टामाइन रिलीज होता है वो जो एलर्जी एंजाइम्स बोलते हैं जिसको हम हिस्टामाइन्स वो जनरली जब बॉडी कुछ और ज्यादा काम नहीं करता है लेट इवनिंग वो 10 11 बजे या 8 9 बजे ही बॉडी से रिलीज होता है व्हेन बॉडी योर ब्रेन इज नॉट यू नो कुछ और काम में वो बिजी नहीं है तो अर्टिकेरिया कोई भी इचिंग मतलब अगर आपको फंगल का भी इचिंग है कुछ भी तो वो जनरली आपको यही फील होगा कि वो शाम को ज्यादा हो रहा है लेट इवनिंग ज्यादा हो रहा है
ओके सो दैट मींस उसका एक रीजन है कि वो शाम को या रात में इट इज मोर एंड इचिंग आल्सो हैपेंस इन मोर ओके डॉक्टर एंड डॉक्टर एज यू हैव मेंशन दैट यू नो वर्स एट नाइट सो व्हाट आर द प्रिकॉशंस और वी कैन से मेडिकेशंस इफ समवन इज टेकिंग बट यू नो स्टिल इचिंग कंटिन्यूज दैट एंड इन नाइट सो आर देयर एनी स्पेशल वी कैन से पाउडर और क्रीम एज वेल
See, powder or creams will give you temporary yes we can add there are anti-itch powders available and anti-itch creams available but that will give you some psychological and some temporary benefit if you don't have anything you can just put coconut oil also so that is also good and otherwise you get anti-itch powders and you have calamine lotions available which comes with anti-itch properties there are two types of calamine
Okay, doctor. And doctor, are there any dietary precautions or do's and don'ts for the people who are having urticaria?
Urticaria in relation of food is not that much high, which is hyped basically. But generally, हम ये बोलते हैं कि अगर urticaria है तो आप ऐसा food खाइए जो gut friendly हो. मतलब अगर आप ऑफकोर्स मतलब आप स्नैकिंग नहीं करोगे आप ईस्ट बेस्ड चीजें जैसे ब्रेड्स है वो सब कम खाओगे जो आपको गट हैवी हो तो आपका सिस्टम क्लीन रहे सो एनीथिंग लाइक जूसेस फ्रेश जूसेस कर्ड हो गया वो अगेन हेल्दी रहता है पैक्ड फूड नहीं खाएंगे ब्रेड्स नहीं खाएंगे यू नो जैसे पाव भाजी वगैरह रहता है या सांभर जिसमें बहुत सारे मिक्स्ड वेजिटेबल्स है वो सब हम बाहर का खाना नहीं खाएंगे यू कैन हैव सिंपल नॉर्मल इंडियन फूड दैट इज ओके यू डोंट नीड टू यू नो कट डाउन एंड जस्ट यू आर हैविंग रोटी एंड मिल्क ऐसा करने की कोई जरूरत नहीं यू जस्ट कट डाउन ऑन द स्पाइसेस
Okay, so cut down on the spices and that can definitely help the people who are having urticaria. So they have to take care of their diet as well. And it is suggested that having a proper diet, as doctor mentioned, is very important if you're having urticaria. Doctors, when someone is, you know, traveling in public transport or using the people who are having urticaria or using their towel, here comes a question that is urticaria contagious?
No, urticaria is not contagious at all because it is a type of you can say your body आपको protect कर रहा है allergy से so it is a protective reaction the body में जो भी जो allergy बढ़ रहा है वो आपको body समझा रहा है it is not at all infectious तो वो मतलब it is not contagious तो वो कोई issue नहीं है urticaria
Okay, so that means if some of your friends or family members is having, it is not contagious. So, you know, because people are scared of sitting with that person. And I think you might have also come across a lot of patient coming that, you know, inhe dur rakhiye, yeah, all the things. Attention to the people who actually do it. So, urticaria is not contagious as doctor told us already. And doctor, what will be your suggestion and advice to all the people who have urticaria and because I think both the ways the people who are having urticaria might also feel that you know I should be away from all the people because urticaria I have skin problem
see first of all for that say koi bhi skin disease hai most of aisa nahi hota hai ki sabke sabhi contagious hote hain And everything can be controlled. So first of all, अगर आपको कोई issue है, you don't need to hide it. You have to get it corrected. One, family members have to be sympathetic. मैंने बहुत बार देखा है लोग इतना खींचते हैं कि वो बहुत बिगड़ जाए, इवन स्पेशली फॉर फंगल इन्फेक्शंस, दे डोंट सी द डॉक्टर एंड दे वर्जन इट. मतलब इफ यू हैव एन इश्यू यू कैन गेट इट सॉल्व, वन. एंड इवन इफ इट इज कंटेजियस तो उसके कुछ नॉर्म्स होते हैं. इट इज नॉट लाइक कोविड, यू नो कि दैट इट इज सो कंटेजियस दैट यू कैन नॉट सिट बिसाइड द पर्सन. तो दैट इज देयर. सो प्रॉपरली आपको डिजीज डॉक्टर के पास समझिए, उसका ट्रीटमेंट कराइए, क्यों हुआ है, वापस ना उसके लिए हम क्या ध्यान रखेंगे वो हम करेंगे. ब्लड इन्वेस्टिगेशंस भी हम लोग करते हैं. मतलब सी अभी अगर हम आपको मेडिकली बताते हैं तो व्हेन अ अर्टिकेरिया पेशेंट कम्स, हम लोग ऑलमोस्ट 10 to 15 मिनट्स सिर्फ हिस्ट्री टेकिंग करते हैं. मतलब आप क्लास राइट फ्रॉम यू नो योर डेली लाइफ रूटीन, आप क्या खाते हैं, आप कितना एक्सरसाइज करते हैं, आपने लास्ट 1.5-2 महीने में क्या अलग किया, आप कई बार घूमने गए थे, फूड, मतलब इट्स अ वेरी लॉन्ग हिस्ट्री, योर वर्क. देयर इज सम, यू विल बी सरप्राइज, देयर इज समथिंग कॉल्ड एज प्रेशर अर्टिकेरिया और वाइब्रेशनल अर्टिकेरिया. जैसे कुछ लोग हैं वो दिन में 30-40 किलोमीटर बाइक चला रहे हैं, सो बिकॉज ऑफ द प्रेशर, द वाइब्रेशन ऑफ द बाइक, यू नो दे गेट स्टार्ट गेटिंग रैशेस. सो प्रेशर अर्टिकेरिया, बहुत टाइट क्लोथ या बहुत कुछ टाइट यूनिफॉर्म पहना है, सो दोज आर वेरियंट्स ऑफ अर्टिकेरिया. कोल्ड अर्टिकेरिया, वैसे बहुत सारे उसके वेरियंट्स रहते हैं. सो इट बिकम्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट कि हम आपको सब एक्सप्लेन कर सके. बट या आप एक ओपन माइंड के साथ जब डर्मेट किसी के पास जाते हैं तो आप उसको एक प्रॉपर हिस्ट्री दीजिए, जिससे वो आपको पूरा समझा के आपकी प्रॉब्लम को सॉल्व कर सके. दूसरा, आई हैव सीन लॉट ऑफ पेशेंट्स जो ये बोलते हैं कि अर्टिकेरिया इज नॉन क्योरेबल, यू नो समवन इन देयर फैमिली एंड नियर माय रिलेटिव टोल्ड दैट. नो, इट इज नॉट ट्रू. इतनी ब्यूटिफुल मेडिसिन अवेलेबल है विच कैन विच ट्रीट्स अर्टिकेरिया. थर्ड मिथ, ऑल एलोपैथ्स गिव स्टेरॉयड. सो दैट इज द बिगेस्ट मिथ. सो सी, स्टीरॉयड इज अ लाइफ सेविंग ड्रग. अगर किसी को एंजियोडीमा हुआ है, जो सांस ही नहीं ले पा रहा है, तो उसको बचाने के लिए स्टीरॉयड देना ही पड़ेगा. बट इट इज नॉट दैट अगर आप किसी भी डिजीज के लिए स्किन स्पेशलिस्ट के पास जा रहे हैं तो आपको स्टीरॉयड ही देगा. सो बिकॉज ऑफ दैट हाफ ऑफ द पीपल डोंट कम टू यू. दैट इज अ वेरी कॉमन मिथ व्हाट आई हैव सीन. सो अर्टिकेरिया इज ट्रीटेबल, ओनली योर डर्मेटोलॉजिस्ट कैन ट्रीट. गेट प्रॉपरली इन्वेस्टिगेटेड फॉर अर्टिकेरिया एंड जस्ट बिलीव इन योर डॉक्टर. अर्टिकेरिया में टाइम लगता है ट्रीट होने के लिए. कभी कभी 2-3 साल तक भी दवाइयाँ देनी पड़ती है जिन लोगों को क्रॉनिक अर्टिकेरिया होता है. So I tell patients, how you take diabetes, BP medicines, you know. So your body is not getting adjusted to the histamine level. So you have to take medicine for that. It is as simple as that.
Right. That means going to a doctor is much. Then I think a lot of people fear it as well, as you said that most people don't come, they don't tell themselves that they have a problem. And I think which is the first step that if you have any kind of skin disease, you must go to a dermatologist, tell the whole history that you know this is happening. Doctor, coming to the treatment part, as you mentioned that there are a lot of medicines available. What are the treatment options which are available for articulation?
See, generally first we investigate the patient. So what is the cause of urticaria? So it could be as simple as blood investigation, allergy test, sometimes abdominal sonographies also if we have a history of repeated stomach infections and all that. So we first find the cause. So accordingly, you have to be anti-allergic, and there are medicines which is known to clear urticaria from your body. So those are given according to the description of your doctor. But जैसे मैंने आपको बताया, जरूरी नहीं है कि हर सारी दवाइयाँ स्टीरॉयड ही होंगी. वो दवाई वो आपका डॉक्टर, बिकॉज वी कैन नॉट डिस्कस मेडिकल मेडिसिन हियर. बट यस, बहुत अच्छी मेडिसिन अवेलेबल है विच आर सेफ. मतलब अगर हम एक छोटे बच्चे को भी देने के लिए, जो बच्चों के अर्टिकेरिया एलर्जीज होते हैं उसमें भी हम लोग दे सकते हैं. इतनी सेफ मेडिसिन अवेलेबल है, बट थोड़ा लंबा चलता है. कोल्ड कफ की तरह नहीं होता कि 10-15 दिन में ठीक हो जाए. यू हैव टू बी मेंटली प्रिपेयर्ड फॉर एटलीस्ट 3 मंथ्स. दैट इज आवर रूल ऑफ थंब. अगर खुजली चली भी जाती है अर्टिकेरिया, देन आल्सो यू हैव टू मेडिकेट द पेशेंट फॉर 3 मंथ्स.
So that means the treatment is long. Articaria will go, but the treatment will be long. So the patient has to be prepared mentally as well that he or she has to take the medicines. And doctor, what your suggestion to the people who don't take full medicines and leave the treatment in halfway only when they see that articaria is gone and there are no rashes or itching, so we should leave the medicines.
True, that is there for all skin problems. So I just tell them one thing, tumne jahan se choda na, jab mere paas aoge wahan se wapas 3 mahine ginna. So that's what I tell them. क्योंकि बॉडी को सिस्टम को हम एडजस्ट कर रहे हैं. सी इट इज अर्टिगेरिया, लाइक आई एम सेइंग अर्टिगेरिया, एक्ने, फंगल इन्फेक्शन, फॉर से एनी स्किन डिजीज. हम लोग बहुत हाई पावर मेडिसिन नहीं देते, तो हम स्लो सस्टेन्ड देते हैं, तो बॉडी का वो जो साइकिल है, रिदम है, उसमें वो बैठ के उसको निकालने के लिए बॉडी टेक्स दैट मच ऑफ टाइम टू क्लियर यू आउट ऑफ दैट. सो दे हैव टू टेक इट लाइक एंड अगेन दे स्टार्ट द साइकिल अगेन.
Right, so they need to understand that taking the full treatment is important, and if you leave the treatment in between, you have to start it again from the beginning. So that is the point of not treating the urticaria. Doctor, we also have some live viewers questions here who are watching this live. We have question that when should someone with urticaria seek medical care?
If like I said, just agar poorer body ka jo involvement hai, it is not as we call it quality of life index. So basically, agar aap bahut zyada aap so pa rahe hain, aap comfortable hain, aap kha pi pa rahe hain, so you can wait for 24 hours. But if it is so much that you are itching badly and your upper body and all that is swollen, then you have to see the doctor. Sometimes जरूरी नहीं है कि आपको dermat, जैसे शाम को हो गया, evening में हो गया, and you are not able to find a dermat. So you can always consult a general physician, which then they can refer to the dermatologist. But don't wait for more than 2 to 3 days if you are having lot of rashes.
Okay, so 2 to 3 days are that days we can, you can see that how it is going, it is okay or not. Okay. Doctor, there is one more question that which food is commonly trigger urticaria?
What could commonly trigger urticaria? For if you're talking about in general, the non-disease part, I feel are the eating raw food, stomach infections is the commonest cause of urticaria in India because of the gut problem. And cold and viral infections in kids. So these are the commonest cause of non-allergic urticaria. मतलब एक allergic urticaria मतलब क्या होता है? Suppose you are allergic to peanuts, for example. तो आप जब भी peanuts खाओगे आपको allergy रहेगा. That is food allergy urticaria. One is कि आपने बाहर का खाना खाया, आपको stomach infect, food poisoning हो गया in short, और उसमें rashes हो रहा है. So infective urticaria I think is the most common in India.
Okay, and doctor, some people also have when they eat ginger or some any kind of product, they got rashes and all. So is it all that food also trigger urticaria?
Sorry, I didn't get the question. I'm sorry.
Food, common food items, we can say,
See, any food which is very pungent, jaise ki vegetarians mein, jaise ki mushrooms ho gaya. मशरूम्स, और जैसे मैंने आपको बताया था, जैसे पाव बोलते हैं ना अपन, जो पाव, बड़ा पाव का पाव होता है, उसमें ईस्ट बहुत ज्यादा होता है. तो जो एकदम स्ट्रॉन्ग प्रोडक्ट्स रहते हैं उसमें, MSG हो गया, जो हम चाइनीज में यूज करते हैं, उन चीजों में अर्टिकेरिया होने के चांसेस, फूड अर्टिकेरिया होने के चांसेस थोड़े ज्यादा होते हैं. नॉन वेजिटेरियन में सी फूड का सबसे ज्यादा, इट इज हाईली प्रॉन्स, प्रॉन्स इज नोन टू बी द मोस्ट हाईली प्रॉन फॉर फिश एंड प्रॉन्स फॉर अर्टिकेरिया. And in India, these kind of foods, mushrooms, yeast wale food, achar, purane kabhi wo chote, jo Gujarat mein bahut khaya jata hai, ek bor ka achar bolte hain, wo aise ekdam bahut khatta hota hai, matlab you know they keep it for long time. So us type ke highly fermented food is known to cause more urticaria.
Okay, and doctor, is it like that someone is alcoholic or smoking, does it also trigger urticaria?
Good question. We actually forgot that. I have seen a lot of patients who come with urticaria and they don't give the history of addictions. Sometimes they hide the history of addictions. So liquor will, in any case, because it is going to compromise your liver and kidney both. So it is going to decrease the good vitamins, B12 and wo sab bhi kam ho jayega. तो उसकी वजह से जो आपको नॉर्मल रैशेस होने वाले थे वो ज्यादा होंगे, एंड यू हैव अ हायर टेंडेंसी ऑफ गेटिंग एलर्जीज बिकॉज़ योर गट एंड लिवर एवरीथिंग इज पुअर. सेम गोज विद टोबैको, सेम गोज विद स्मोकिंग. सो एडिक्शन विल कॉज मोर अर्टिकेरिया, एंड ऑल्सो आपका जो हीलिंग टाइम है वो भी बढ़ा देगा, क्योंकि आपका ओवरऑल इम्यूनिटी, बॉडी का जो फाइटिंग कैपेसिटी है वो खराब है. तो फॉर श्योर एडिक्शन, इवन
as simple as we, what do you call them, these monster drinks with high caffeine. They also for the teenagers take. So they are again very highly chemical, high quality of chemicals. So usme bhi ye maine urticaria zyada hota hai, allergic.
Okay, so that means smoking and you know if someone is drinking water, that can also trigger urticaria. And as you have mentioned that it is important that some people even that don't know that they are addicted to you know these things and having urticaria because of this. Right, doctor. Doctor, there is one more question from a viewer that can pressure on the skin cause urticaria?
Yeah, I had explained that, right? So urticaria, I'll just say it very fast. Food urticaria, allergic urticaria, then inhalation. This is kisi ko spray ya agarbatti se urticarias hote hain. Then pressure urticaria. So it is wherever you wear a tight strap or a belt, you get urticaria. Then vibrational urticaria. कुछ लोगों को वाटर अर्टिकेरिया एक्वाजेनिक नहाते हैं रैशेज हो जाते हैं 5 मिनट में चले जाता है सो दैट इज एक्वाजेनिक वन इज हीट अर्टिकेरिया आप धूप में जा रहे हैं और आप पूरे लाल हो गए अंदर आ गया ठीक हो जाए सो देयर इज ऑल दे आर ऑल वेरिएंट्स ऑफ अर्टिकेरिया यस यू गेट प्रेशर अर्टिकेरिया
Right, and when you mentioned that बहुत सारे लोगों को water से urticaria होता है, there is a question from our live viewer as well that can cold water from shower cause urticaria? As my son often develop itching after having bath.
Itching after having bath.
Right, because उसमें दो चीजें हो सकती हैं कि एक जो shower का जो pressure आ रहा है, या तो उनको pressure urticaria होगा, तो उनको bucket से आके देखना पड़ेगा कि basically it's pressure urticaria और water urticaria. तो
okay.
उसे और कुछ लोगों को नहाने के बाद टाल रब करते हैं तब अर्टिकेरिया होता है सो अगेन इट इज फ्रिक्शनल अर्टिकेरिया सो यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई दैट्स व्हाई हिस्ट्री इज वेरी वी समटाइम्स स्पेंड 20 25 मिनट्स विद द पेशेंट जस्ट टू गैदर द हिस्ट्री एंड अंडरस्टैंड हाउ टू क्योर इट
Right, because it is important that what is the reason of urticaria? As you mentioned that there are different types of urticaria, so you have to find that what is the reason of urticaria. Doctor, is urticaria genetic? If someone in the family have the history of urticaria, does it happen like that?
Not really, but yes, some people have a tendency of overproducing histamine. So, जैसे किसी के family में किसी को asthma है, तो asthma is a kind of allergy जो दमा बोलते हैं अपन हिंदी में और किसी को एक्जिमास है या वो है तो देर इज अ फैमिलियर टेंडेंसी ऑफ डेवलपिंग हाइपर आईजीई और हाइपर हिस्टामिन सो यस इट हैज अ फैमिली प्रीडिस्पोजिशन पर ऐसा नहीं है कि अगर आपको अर्टिकेरिया है तो आपके किड्स को होगा ही मतलब ऐसे इतना ट्रांसफरेबल नहीं होता है बट ठीक है थोड़ा सा एक फैमिलियर टेंडेंसी रहता है अर्टिकेरिया का एलर्जीज का
Okay, so that means it is not necessary that it will pass on, but if when someone is coming, they should take more. Right, right, doctor. And doctor, here's one more question that can urticaria cause a fever?
Yeah, that is a bad medical disease. So urticaria with fever is a proper disease. Which is due to a lot of reasons, but urticaria with fever and urticaria जैसे जब urticaria के rashes हुए और हमने उसको press किया, अगर वो painful है, उछलाहट है, जलन है, burning sensation is there, that is okay. But if you touch and it feels pain, like as if you got hurt, then you have to see the doctor immediately. So urticaria तो measurable fever, मतलब touch कर रहे हैं तो गर्म रहेगा, but if you have proper जो thermometer में आपका fever आ रहा है You have to see the doctor immediately. So those are medical illnesses, and you have to see the doctor.
Okay, that means if you have any kind of symptom, you should go to a doctor instead of self-medicating or you know doing home remedies, as doctor already mentioned. Doctor, you only mentioned about the lip swelling, but there is a question that can urticaria cause swelling of the lips as well, and why?
Can urticaria cause the swelling of
lips?
Yeah, of course. See, there are some urticarias which you will not have anything, and suddenly you get swelling of the lips and even swelling of the eyes, and which is very dangerous. This generally happens with strong inhalants. Is that कोई भी formalin या कोई बहुत strong sa inhalant कुछ सूंघ लिया और like मैंने जो आपको food बताया था very commonly with seafood and mushrooms and all that, all of a sudden you start swelling, and by the time you realize, you start choking. If someone is highly allergic to, or some medicines also, so in that case, you may have only lip urticaria, only lip angioedema also.
Okay, as we have seen, and you know, a lot of people have you know, smells flowers, and then they are like sneezing, when they have the redness on the face,
then start itching on the face. Yeah, even bee stings, they also cause such kind of rashes.
Okay, and does that cause urticaria as well? No, that is a kind of urticaria as well.
See, basically urticaria allergy, उनका बहुत thin border of difference रहता है. So urticaria is basically a medical term for rashes. So hives बोल दो, allergy बोल दीजिए, कुछ भी बोल दीजिए. So those are all different types of itching on the body, which is to be diagnosed as urticaria or not is a doctor's job. Like you see lot of allergic itching in dengue. I had last year seen so many people who came to us with itching, and they were having dengue. So you know, sometimes it comes like that also.
Okay. Whenever you are having any kind of itching or redness, again and again and frequently, please go and refer to the dermatologist, because it is important that it should be treated properly, and don't leave the treatment halfway. As we have already discussed, that taking the full treatment is important, otherwise you have to start with zero. And I think very helpful information for all our viewers as well. Doctor, before we end this informative live session, any advice you would like to give to all our viewers watching this live?
If God forbid you get the disease, you have to see the doctor. That we have spoken almost 100 times. But what you can do from your own part, any doctor would tell that, you know, follow a few steps, like a good diet, a good healthy exercise, drink water, maintain a sleep pattern. You would say, how would that help in urticaria? But trust me, it does. And because of our stress level, what we have to in these days, you know, our urticaria or any skin, even as simple as psoriasis and all those days, we always tell them, you do all this, you know, the negative enzymes which is created in the body, they really improve by just with your mind power. So these things help. Sometimes only, you know, popping up pills don't help you. So you have to go in hand with the doctor, understand your body and take proper care. So cut down on junk. Have a good you know, local Indian food, that would surely help, and lot of exercise and meditation.
Okay, that means a healthy lifestyle will actually help you to, you know, help in curing the urticaria, and also prevention. If we talk about prevention, this is the better prevention with, you know, eating healthy, as you have mentioned, that avoiding junk food and not eating junk food can definitely help. And I think urticaria, and we have discussed about the causes as well, the other types of causes as well. Viewers have also asked questions. Any takeaway message for all our viewers, doctor, who are watching this live?
I think I have said the whole thing again and again. So whoever is watching, 3 to 4 things. We are blessed to stay in India, and your doctor is one call away. So please take care, take help from your doctor. One, don't self-medicate, don't medicate your family members, because the repercussions are very bad. Lead a healthy lifestyle, and you know, okay, we are Indians, we are foodies. So let me say, I'll not say don't eat junk food, but today if you're having a pizza, so you know, next din thoda sa green vegetables zyada kha lijiye, neutralize your body. So let us put it that way, and avoid addictions and keep yourself healthy.
It's avoid addiction, keep yourself healthy, and balance your diet as well. As doctor said, that agar ek din aap pizza khare to dusre din you can eat healthy, because that can help. Balancing is important. But thank you so much, Dr. Priyanka Sudaria, for your valuable time, and it has been very informative session for viewers.
Thank you so much for calling me. Thank you so much.
thank you doctor, and I'm sure they will use this information to prevent themselves and their near and dear ones from getting urticaria as well. And I think they know now that if they get the symptoms, instead of self-medication, it's better to approach a nearby dermatologist. It is great to hear you, doctor. And we really look forward for many more much sessions in the coming time as well.
Absolutely. Pleasure is mine.
Thank you. Thank you so much, doctor. And thank you, viewers, for your excellent participation in today's session. To get latest updates on how to keep your skin healthy, do like and follow our Facebook page. That is All About Skin Wellbeing. We are also available on YouTube, Twitter, and Instagram. Thank you and good day to all.